Religion analysis refers to the process whereby a firm determines the cost associated with organizational activities from purchasing raw materials to manufacturing products to marketing those products. It aims to identify where low-cost advantages or disadvantages exist anywhere along the value chain from raw materials to customer service activities. So if you look at the textbook as well, it does not provide any figure or any chart that showing how does a value chain might be effective. But let us check this out. If you look at the Google, bila kita tengok dalam Google, value chain analysis is considered as one of the strategy tool to analyze internal firm activities. Its goal is to recognize which activities are the most valuable. For example, the source of cost or differentiation advantage to the firm and which ones could be improved to provide competitive advantage. Let us take one example. This is a product value chain analysis yang mana these are all their important activities. These are all their main activities, lalu dia dekat atas. And then these are all the supporting activities. For every company, they have different value chain. It depends on what are the functions that you perform in your organization. Kalau kita tengok yang tadi, sebab tadi dalam buku ni cakap pasal daripada raw material sampai ke apa kan? Okay, kita ambil yang ni. Dia tak nampak jelas, tapi dekat sini, these are the portal value chain for primary activities. Dia tak nampak jelas, tak apa. Kita tengok image. Better. Okay, yes. Kita tengok. So, this is one of the value chain yang mana these are the support activities and this is the primary activities. So, macam mana this value chain can become your source of competitive advantage? Organization needs to decide dekat mana yang dia cost efficient, dekat mana yang dia ada element differentiation. Mungkin dia punya element differentiation dekat marketing and sales. And the way dia orang punya buat promotion gempak gila. And then yang itu lebih advance, lebih baik lah, lebih menarik lah in terms of dia punya marketing channel, for example. And for some people, maybe in terms of the operation, because dari segi cost, dia punya operation dia ada lori-lori untuk fleet of lorries yang boleh handle all the transportation dia part. So they don't have to hire ataupun rent over the transportation. But for some other organisation pula, maybe dia punya operation juga is the main competitive advantage sebab dia tak ada lorry. Dia just bayar sewa, so dia tak ada maintenance cost, dia tak payah nak bayar renew road tax, tak payah nak renew insurance, tak payah nak bayar driver, dia cuma bayar sewa lorry saja. Maybe that is the source of differentiation and cost advantage to the organisation. So I just want to show you an example of a value chain. So let us go back to our lecture. Kita dah nak habis. One of the way that organization can do in order to develop their value chain is through benchmarking. Benchmarking, kalau kita tengok dulu masa when I was in the United States, masa saya belajar dekat sana, saya masa tu lagi saya dah tengok video macam mana Honda bought over a Toyota punya kenderaan and then they strip down everything. Dan sampai into pieces, dia susun every single equipment ataupun parts of the car. Same goes to Toyota. Toyota also bought over Honda Mercedes and they strip it down into every single bolts and nuts. Because of why? Because they want to do benchmarking. They want to know to identify dekat kereta Honda ni apa elemen yang Toyota tak ada and vice versa. And that's what we mean by benchmarking. Kita nak identify kan, dekat mana value chain activities that are competitive as compared to rival. So bila kita ada this value chain between two similar companies operating in the same areas, then you can understand kenapa kos kita lebih mahal berbanding dengan diorang. Dekat area value chain mana yang kita punya kos lebih tinggi. Then you can start to focus on minimizing the cost in the future. So this is how you can transform value chain activities. Kan? Mula-mula kita identify what are the value chain activities yang terlibat. And then kita tengok daripada macam gambar tadi, mana satu kita punya core competency. Katalah core competency kita dekat marketing, kita punya marketing hebat. So that core competency kita boleh develop into becoming kita punya distinctive competency, so that people cannot copycat the way that we promote our product. And finally, that core competency could yield some sustainable competitive advantage. Okay, the last one. Yang ni yang paling penting sebenarnya, sebab dia sangat relevant related dengan korang punya group project. Last week, saya dah minta korang come up with a SWOT analysis. Kan? So, for this week, kita akan buat the second part of the SWOT, which is the strength and weaknesses, which relate dengan IFE metric. Like I said before, soalan pernah keluar dalam final exam, asking student to identify macam mana nak conduct internal factor evaluation. Dia sama saja macam FPFE, nah, tetapi dia ada dua elemen yang berbeza yang saya nak korang dengar betul-betul. Sebab yang ni bila korang nak buat dalam korang punya group project, nah, dia sangat-sangat berkait rapat. Yang pertama sekali, yes, you need to list all of the strengths and weaknesses. Each of the group akan cari 5-6 strength dan juga 4-5 weaknesses. Nah, korang kena cari. Yang kedua, you are going to assign the weight. Kan? Macam mana kita nak assign weight, kita just identify mana satu faktor yang rasa penting for the organization, so we put on higher weights. For example, like this one, evaluation metrics for retail computer store, the highest weight dia letak dalam revenues for segment, repair and service segment, up by 16%, iaitu dia letak 0.15, dan juga location of store negatively impacted by new highway. That is a weakness. Sebab apa? Sebab dekat kedai dia ada highway baru tengah nak bina. So kalau highway baru tengah nak bina, kita semua faham, very congested area and people don't go and use that particular route anymore. So that has a huge impact on this particular company. And then in terms of the rating, kalau kita tengok sedikit, ada perbezaan yang sangat ketara dengan EFE, yang mana rating untuk strength cuma 3 dan 4 sahaja. You look at your notes carefully. Dan ratings untuk weaknesses hanya 1 and 2 sahaja. So please do not make that mistake when you conduct your own evaluation metrics for IFE dan juga EFE. Yang pertama, listing semua sama. Strength, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. Yang kedua, kita akan calculate the weight. Make sure strength and weaknesses kita akan dapat 1, opportunities and threats kita akan dapat 1 juga, kan? And then in terms of the rating, kalau EFE kita boleh letak 1 sampai 4. 1 meaning that dia punya respond towards that particular element is not that effective, very poorly respond, kan? Tapi 4 sebagai highly respond, they have good strength ataupun good response towards that particular element. But for the IFE, only for the strength, kita letak 3 dan 4. Kan? Sama ada they are very very good ataupun ranking dia sama ada nombor 3 atau nombor 4. Dan untuk weaknesses, 1 ataupun 2. 1 yang paling weak, 2 is a little bit better lah, kan? Than the number 1 punya factor. So that's how you need to do. And then you multiply, kita akan dapat weighted score and you are going to get this value for your IFE. So this is what you are going to do for your group project, and that is the end of the chapter. So peace out.